If you get a piece of toast and it falls to the ground, it will always land put aside down. But if you get a domestic cat and it falls to the street, it will always land upon its feet. Which makes me wonder what would happen if I got a bit of buttered toast and gaffer-tent it onto the back of a cat and threw it out of a tower block. How would it know how to land? How would it know how to land? The cat would try to land upon his feet and get the buttery toes upon his back. He tried to land upon his buttery side. How would he know how to land? How would he know how to land? The cat would try to land upon his feet, but the buttery toes upon his back would try to land upon his buttery side. Which means the cat would simply spin forever about 18 inches above the ground. That's where it would be found. Anti-gravity cats. Anti-gravity cats. Anti-gravity cats. Cats we toss on their backs. Anti-gravity cats. Cats we toss on their backs. Thrown out of blocks of flats. Anti-gravity cats. You could even use them as a kind of turbine machine. Thousands of spinning cats would produce a lot of electricity without us having to rely on fossil fuels or nuclear power at all. And the carbon emissions from a spinning domestic cat would be relatively small. And perhaps the cats would try and escape by licking the butter off the toast, but they wouldn't be able to reach it, so they'd be stuck spinning round and round. I think it could work. I'm gonna buy myself 10 loaves of bread and get down the RSPCA on Leeds Road with some gaffer tape tomorrow morning, as soon as I wake up. Anti-gravity cats. Anti-gravity cats. Anti-gravity cats. Cats we touch on their backs. Anti-gravity cats. Anti-gravity cats. Anti-gravity cats. Chuck them out of blocks of flats.